We're back with the database for our diary app. Now, when we first created these tables, like the diary logs table, we decided to store user ID, date, and content. And now I want you to imagine that a few months after we launched this diary app, a user designer suggests adding a how are you feeling dropdown on each diary entry. And the user would say something like happy or sad or confused. In order to store that, we need to add an emotion column to the table. Now, we could just add it like this, but if this was a database for an app in a real production environment, then we couldn't just edit the create statement because that's something that we actually issued months ago and it's already happened. And if we rerun it, it'll actually remove the current data. And we don't want to lose all the data that we've gotten over these many months. So at this point, after we've done create and after we've got data, we're going to need to use the alter table statement. And to use that, we write alter table and then the name of the table, and then add, then the name of the column name we're adding, and then the data type of that new column. Great. So now the next time that the user makes an entry, we'll need to specify that column, or we can specify that column. So let's say, all right, let's say they went to Disneyland. And to specify that new column, we're going to put comma emotion. And then here we'll just say happy. Most people are happy that go there. Okay, so let's see what it looks like now if we select it all. So we can see the latest row has happy in the emotion column, and the row before it has that big old null in it. And that is what databases usually do. They fill in null for unspecified values. If we want, we can actually get it to fill in some other value for rows where it wasn't set, and that's what we think of as the default value for a column. So to do that, if we had wanted to do that, we would have put default and then the value in that alter table statement when we ran it. So now you can see instead of null, we see unknown. So that's an option for you when you're adding a column, and just something to keep in mind, depends what you're adding to the database. Okay, so now let me show you something that you rarely do, deleting an entire table. Maybe I would do this if I migrated all the data out of this table into some new table, or if I just got mad and decided to be a horrible person and take a rampage all over a database. That's bad. But anyway, we can do this using the drop table statement. And now if I try to select, what happens? I actually get an error because my table no longer exists, so it can't select from it. So that was a bad idea, and I'll just delete it. You should think really carefully about dropping tables. Do not just drop them willy-nilly. You should also be careful with alter table, especially if you're running it on a table with a lot of rows, because you can have performance issues there. Really, I don't want to scare you, but you should be careful whenever you're making any changes to your database. With great power comes great responsibility. And now you have both,